Oh, right, YouTubers, welcome back to War Thunder Ground Forces with the Angry Nerd. And today I thought we would take a look at the premium Panzerbefehlswagen IV. Now, the Panzer IV was a German medium tank developed in the late 1930s and used extensively during the Second World War. Originally designed as an infantry support tank, the Panzer IV was not intended to engage enemy armor. That role was allocated to the Panzer III. However, in the face of Soviet T-34 and KV-1 tanks, the Panzer IV soon assumed the role of its increasingly vulnerable cousin. The Panzer IV was the most widely manufactured and deployed German tank of the Second World War. It was used as the basis for many other fighting vehicles. Robust and reliable, it saw service in all combat theaters involving Germany and was notable for being the only German tank to remain in continuous production throughout the war, with over 8,800 produced between 1936 and 1945. Upgrades and design modifications were intended to counter new threats and extend its service life. Generally, these involved increasing the Panzer IV's armor protection or upgrading its weapons. However, it was also modified for command and control purposes. The Panzerbefehlswagen IV was a command tank variant of the Panzer IV. It was only developed when supply of similar vehicles based on the Panzer III began to run dry in the spring of 1944. Command vehicles of medium tank battalions were built based on the standard Panzer IV Aust J, as well as other refurbished models. Despite addressing mobility problems introduced by the previous models, the final production version, the Panzer IV Aust J, was considered a retrograde from the Panzer IV Aust H. Born of German necessity to replace heavy losses, it was greatly simplified to speed production. The electric generator that powered the tank's turret traverse was removed, so the turret had to be rotated manually. The pistol and vision ports in the turret were also removed, and the side skirts had been replaced by wire mesh. The number of return rollers were also reduced from 4 to 3 to further speed production. While nearly the same exterior-wise, the inside of the Panzerbefehlswagen was refitted with new equipment to enhance communications. The conversion allowed the tank to mount additional radio sets for communicating with headquarters, other tanks, infantry, artillery, and even aircraft. The loader of the tank doubled as the radio operator and was also responsible for maintaining all radios in the tank. The new equipment in the tank took up space that had been allocated for ammunition stowage, so the ammo loadout was reduced from 87 rounds to 72 rounds, but this is mitigated by the fact that it was not supposed to be a frontline weapon against the enemy, thus fighting was not its intended role. Other than that, the tank is nearly the same as the original Panzer IV-J. The tank featured a 75mm KWK 40 L-48 main gun with a coaxial MG-34 machine gun. The tank was used in battles on the Eastern and Western fronts from 1944 to 1945. Now in War Thunder, the Panzerbefehlswagen IV is a rank 3 with a battle rating of 4.3. It has a 572 horsepower engine propelling the 25-ton vehicle to a top speed of 26.7 miles per hour. It comes equipped with the 75mm KWK 40 L-48 cannon, and with a maxed out crew, you can achieve a reload of 6.2 seconds, but it has a horrible turret rotation speed of 6.6 degrees per second. Since it's a premium, it has a reward of 100% plus 100%. And a research point bonus of 208%. So what do I think of the Panzerbefehlswagen here in War Thunder? Well, it's okay. The mobility is nice, and that L-48 cannon is a very good weapon for this tier. But that turret rotation speed has sort of put me off on this vehicle, as well as the regular Panzer IV-J in the standard tech tree. I don't particularly like that one very much either. I like a little faster turret rotation. So after the gameplay, we'll go over and do a little comparison for some different options if you're considering this as a premium vehicle for you. But first, let's hop into a game, see what I was able to do with the Panzerbefehlswagen IV. Okay, it looks like we picked up one of the new winter maps, and I have no idea how to pronounce this, so you know I'm not even gonna try. But let's see. Everything looks pretty good. I think we can just go ahead and hit that battle button. Alrighty, let's see. Okay. What's up with the sound? Why do I have no sound? Oh, I know, I had the sound turned down. I was recording some footage there. Sorry about that. Okay, that's better. I like to be able to hear. Okay, so we are gonna see if we can use the terrain for our advantage. I'm gonna try to stay in these little low points, work our way around, and try to get some flanking shots on the enemy. But I really don't want to crest the hill if I can help it, but I'm gonna get over the top of this and start getting back down on the backside of this hill. Okay, so we're back down in the low section. I can see some of the enemy markers to my right front. So now I need to find a place to engage. Oh, hold on. Wasn't expecting to see him. And I don't think he was expecting to see me either. See how slow that turret traverses. Oh man, it's really bad. Especially if you're getting in close quarters. Oh, get on. Dang it. Hit his gun. Come on. Okay, let's move over to this side and kill the other person. Oh, maybe the driver. Let's see. Dang! Finally! We are lucky that he did not kill us with that shot. I don't know why it took so long to kill him. Uh-oh. Okay, so we've taken out their gunner. Let's see if we can knock out the driver. There we go. Whew! Lucky, lucky, lucky. All right, we got away with two of them. Move our way around, see if we can get a better flanking shot. Okay. Alright, hit his cannon breech. It's hard to track on him. Got him. But we took a nice hit. Took out our driver, wounded some other people, repairing the engine. Hopefully nobody comes down and whops me. All right, we're back in business. It's hard for me to get a bead on him with the turret traverse being as slow as it is. I'm gonna move back around this way. See if I'm get some more flanking shots. They're capping B. I don't see anybody up here right this minute. Okay, let's head back. Somebody, I see somebody on the mini map. See somebody. I'm hoping they will engage the other tank first. That'll give me time to engage them. Here they are. Do I have a shot? Not really. I'm gonna have to move. Still no shot. Huh. Good. Teammate took him out. Alright. Keeping an eye on the mini map. Let's see. We may be able to go right up here. See this little bitty dip right in here? The little hill to the left. May help conceal us just a little bit. Okay, we got a vehicle to the front. Oh, here we go. This guy sees us. Okay, hit him in the cannon. Cannon breach, I guess. Back off. Back down the hill a little bit. Hopefully he will come after me, because I'll have an easier time shooting uphill than he will have shooting downhill with his gun depression. So I'm gonna see if he'll chase me down here. Just want to reposition just a little bit. Okay, let's see. Where is he coming? Oh, he got taken out. Okay. Well, it was a nice plan anyway. Almost worked. All right, what do we got here? Booyah! Alright. Looking at the mini map, I don't really see any one little red dot. Ah, there. Right there. What do we got? Not a shot. Let's move up just a tad. There. All right, try it again, a little lower. Okay, maybe a little bit more. Okay, one more. There we go. Oh, something else. Nice, it works for me. All right, we got anything else? We have all three cap points. The ticker's gonna be running down fairly quickly. Let's pull forward down into this little depression down here. Get a little closer just in case we can get another shot. Oh, Nope, that's it. It's all done. Okay, let's see what we did. Alrighty. Okay. Picked up supporting fire, tank rescuer, professional, shadow strike streak, multi-strike, and one shot. Okay, we destroyed 7 enemy vehicles, 1 assist. 5th place in the team. 48,026 silver lions. We were running a bonus. 7. All right, let's save it. Okay. There we go. Okay, so that was a look at the Panzerbefehlswagen IV with a little gameplay and stuff. But hold on, what is this? Get reward. Okay, so do I think the Panzerbefehlswagen IV is a good premium tank to buy? Well, I think that if you just absolutely have to have a German Tier 3 premium tank, I would go for the KV-1B over the other two options, the Panzer 470A or the Panzerbefehlswagen. That's just my own personal opinion. But if you don't like the slow speed and lack of maneuverability that you would get with the KV-1B, there are some other options that you may want to consider before going for the Panzerbefehlswagen. Let's take a look at those. Okay, so what you see on your screen right now is a comparison between 3 different tanks. The Panzer IV Aust G with a talisman, the Panzer IV Aust H with a talisman, and the premium Panzerbefehlswagen. Now this is the order that I personally would choose, except I would disregard the Panzerbefehlswagen and go with a KV-1B there. So let's take a look. The Panzer IV Aust G, a talisman for that will cost you 1,100 golden eagles. Now it's still a rank 3. It has a battle rating of 4.3. It comes equipped with the 75mm KWK-40L43 cannon, and it has a turret rotation speed of 12.9 degrees per second. It has a reward, a standard reward of 100%, and a research point bonus of plus 42%. Now, the talisman will give you an additional plus 142% for a total of plus 184%. Now, if you just have to have that KWK L48 cannon and some side skirts, you could go with the Panzer IV Aust H. A talisman on that is 1,200 golden eagles, but it will boost your battle rating to 4.7. It has the 75mm KWK L48. It has a turret rotation speed of 11.5. It has a standard reward of 110%. It has a research point bonus of plus 48%. The talisman will give you another plus 148 for a total of +196%. Now, what a premium will get you above and beyond what a talisman will get you is extra reward. Your talisman is going to get you extra research, but the premium will give you extra reward. And you can see the Befehlswagen will cost you 1,750 Golden Eagles. It's a battle rating of 4.3. It has the KWK L48 75mm cannon, but that turret rotation speed of 6.6 degrees is absolutely horrible. It has reward of 100% plus 100% and a research point bonus of plus 208%. So that extra 100% of reward is more Silver Lions in-game currency. But if you're already running a premium account, that is really not that important. If you look at my Silver Lion account, I'm at like 18.6 million, and I spend Silver Lions like they're going out of style. Gadget is not giving me any extra Silver Lions. So as you play the game for a while, and especially if you're running the premium, you're going to build those up, and it's not really going to be an issue. So when I'm thinking of talismans or premium vehicles, I'm totally considering the research, not the reward. I use them in conjunction with the boosters, the research boosters. Don't forget about those. So it's all about the research for me. And as you can see, you got plus 184, plus 196, or plus 208. Not that much of a difference. Okay, so on a different note, I would like to remind everyone that if you are a subscriber to the channel, to make sure you go over and enter that M10 Achilles starter pack giveaway. You can find a link for that video down in the description. And if you have already entered, I want to make sure that I emphasize that you have your subscriptions public, so that when I do the drawing and I go to look to see if you're subscribed to me, that I'll be able to see it. Because if they're hidden, I won't be able to see it. I'm just gonna pick somebody else. So make sure you have those your subscribers public, so that we'll be able to see those. If you liked this look at the Panzerbefehlswagen IV, hit that like button. If you didn't, don't. Please subscribe. It really helps the channel. But as always, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Nerd out.